we are going to talk about today's ratio proportion. Let us first understand the word ratio. What do you mean by ratio? P by Q form. Okay. What else? Three things. First, ratio is a comparison. Two, same quantities. Obviously, when you are comparing, you can compare only same things or similar things. You cannot compare two different things. For example, you cannot compare height with temperature or temperature with weight. You can't do that. You can compare two temperatures, you can compare two speeds, you can compare two weights. So, this is a comparison between same quantities. And another important aspect is carrying same units. So, if you are comparing speed, you cannot compare the speed of a bicycle with speed of a rocket. Right? You can possibly compare the speed of a bicycle with a scooter or a speed of a scooter with a speed of a car. Beyond that, if their units are different, you can't compare. So, meter per second can be compared with meter per second. Kilometer per hour can be compared with kilometer per hour. Let us say I compare quantity. That is, number of boys is to number of girls in a class. If I say number of boys is 8 and number of girls is equal to 12 or is 12, what is the ratio of boys is to girls?
2
is to 3. Very simple. 2 is to 3. No confusion. Now, a ratio does not give me the exact numbers. It does not. Number of boys, if would have been 20 and 30, again the ratio would have been same. If it would have been 40 and 60, again ratio would have been the same. So, ratio does not give you the quantity, the actual quantity. Ratio only gives you a comparison. That is, to every two boys in the class, there are three girls. Clarity? No problem. It is demonstrated as a colon 2 is to 3 and can also be written in the form P by Q. Now, the moment I write P by Q, automatically the units get cancelled. So, it is a unitless quantity. Ratio is a unitless quantity. Is that clear? Absolutely. So, I can say comparing two or more than two aspects or more than two quantities with themselves, I can compare them with the platform of ratio. Moving beyond, the first type of questions which you will encounter in the area of ratio will be balancing of ratios. Now, what do you mean by balancing of ratios? There may be a question where it is said that A is to B is equal to 2 is to 3. B is to C is 3 is to 5. And C is to A is equal to 5 is to 7. What is happening? I have got three different ratios. Now the answer which he looks forward, C is to D, sorry, not A. C is to D, is 5 is to 7. Now he wants to know what is A ratio D. So there are two ways to do it. One, I write A is to B is to C is to D. I know A is to B is 2 is to 3. B is to C is 3 is to 5. And C is to D is 5 is to 7. Once it is 2 is to 3, this is 3 is to 5, can I transform the number from the first ratio to the second one? It is same. Same is true, 2 and 3 become common, they can be transferred here because 5 is common. Now let us say these ratios are different. 1 is 2 is to 3, second one is 2 is to 5, third one is 3 is to 7. 2 is to 3, 2 is to 5, 3 is to 7. All ratios become different. How do you balance the ratios? You will multiply this entire thing by 2 and this entire thing by 3. So what do you get? 2 2s are 4, is to 6, common ho gaya 6, is to 15. Then I multiply this entire thing by 15 and this entire thing by 3. I get 12 is to 18 is to 45 is to 105. So my ratio A is to D is 12 is to 105. Agreed? This is balancing of ratios. In same sort of question, another way of doing it can be A by B into B by C into C by D. Do you not get A by D? Simple. Put the values 2 by 3 into 2 by 5 into 3 by 7. What do you get? 3 2s are 6 2s are 12. 7 5s are 35 3s are 105. That is the answer. Everyone, for sure.